Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson, I will discuss about the spot healing brush tool and the healing brush tool. So let's start with the spot healing brush tool. Using this tool, you can remove this kind of spots with just single click. First, we need to create a layer here so that we can keep our changes within this layer. Spot removal. To remove this kind of spots using this tool, you need to increase the stamp size little bit bigger than the spot. You can also change the diameter of this stamp from here using this slider. After adjusting, you can just click once and that will be gone. So you can also drag like this to remove any spot. It's very simple to use. Let's increase it with the right square bracket and click once. And if I click here once, then you can see we have a white shade here. That's because of this white areas. We can apply here the cone stamp tool to overcome this problem. Let's choose the spot healing brush tool again. To remove these foldings from the forehead, we will not use the cone stamp tool or the spot healing brush tool. Rather, we will use the healing brush tool. Like the cone stamp tool, we need to select a source to clone. So we will choose this fresh area and we need to click and hold the Alt from the keyboard and click here once. And then we can drag from these areas and that will remove those areas. Again, we can source from here and drag. Let's increase the stamp. We can again sample from here and drag like this. Basically, it works like the cone stamp tool. The difference is it heals or minimizes the difference between the source and the target areas using the surroundings. We will see another example of using healing brush tool that will make it clearer. Let's do some other corrections. So that's before and after. Let's see another example of healing brush tool. We want to clone this aircraft into this image. So let's see what happens if we choose the cone stamp tool for cloning. We need to hold Alt and click here to sample, and then we will go to this image and let's create another layer and make sure you selected the sample as all layers. So that's the result of cloning. We need to fix all this manually to make it perfect. And also you can see the color of this aircraft is completely different than the background. It doesn't match with this background. So let's delete this layer and use the healing brush tool for this purpose. Hold Alt and click here. Let's drag. So now you can see how nicely it heals the difference between the source and this target areas. So that's why we will choose the healing brush tool in this kind of uses. Now we can select the cone stamp tool to fix this. Let's choose the healing brush tool again. That's looking nice. Again, we need to choose the cone stamp tool. Let's decrease the stamp. So now it's not that perfect, but it's good enough to use. So in this way you can use the cone stamp tool and the healing brush tool together. And sometimes it's a bit confusing which one to choose among the cone stamp tool and the healing brush tool. You need to select it wisely. So that's it, and thanks for watching. Hope to see you in the next lesson.